without your top two centermen, Jason Arnott out, David Legault, you have to be letter perfect if you're the Preds.
Here's Datsun's shuttling pass to Holmstrom, arrived there at the same time but couldn't direct it on the net. Rafalski bank pass, poked ahead. Bronson trying to get to it. Bronson and poking at it was Ellis. He missed it. A centering pass was intercepted by Suter, or it would have been an easy tap-in goal for the Red Wings. Here's Cronwall back to the line. A drive gets through and fired wide by Bronson. Now Samuelson gets it to the net, and Ellis holds it there. An excellent shift for that second line that we talked about at the very top of the show. Now the Predators look to come out with it. Big collision there between Stewart, the defenseman for Detroit, Darcy Hordichuk, who's going to put another hit on Cleary right in front of the Red Wing bench and then has something to say to him. Comes Alexander Radulov. He hands it off. Good chance on the rush here, and Oscar the save. He has to fight it a little bit there against Radek Bach, but able to not give up a rebound. The Rangers can end that series. Faceoff win by the Wings, and a outlet pass down to Franzen. Johan Franzen, who had the first goal of this series. Nice pass ahead. 3-on-2. Here's Phil Fulham with a shot. Oh, did that go in? They're going to look at that. I think that's a goal. Red light now goes on. It definitely hit iron. You can hear it. But I think Phil Fulham is going to have his first goal of the series, his first point of the series on this shot from the left wing.
That's what they needed. Phil Fulham with the wicked wrister rising. May have hit the iron, certainly. Now we have to tell if it hit the mesh after it hit the iron. Eric Furlatt, the official, just out of frame, bottom left. He pointed immediately. But there was a delay with the goal light, which is no longer definitive either. It's more of an indication for the fans in the building. And that was quick.
It is a goal.
Great job by Eric Furlan. He was right on it. And that's all positioning by the referee. Barry Trotz didn't like the position of trailing 1-0. Filppula, guy we talked about. Those guys, Cleary, Filppula, Franzen, they have to be a factor in the attack tonight.
Slowing it down here as we heard it hit iron. And it snuck in just under the bar. May have hit the back bar. That may have been what we heard. And the Predators come up with it.
Well, you can already see in the early going, Dan Ellis does give up rebounds. He'd like to have given up a rebound on the Filppula goal.
Yeah, exactly. Erad handled off a shot here, handled by Oscar, juggled for a moment. And again, Radek Fox had a couple of chances from the side. And now Franzen and Erad, and immediately Radulov came in. So it gets very testy here in the first 5 minutes. Again, the Predators without Jason Arnott, without David Legault, their top two centers. We were told in Arnott's case he is ill. And Legault, it's that foot. Here's Cleary, burst of speed. He gets by Sidlinski, and a save made by Ellis. And then Draper, some contact with a goaltender. And boy, I give Cleary a lot of credit because there was a little contact in the neutral zone. If he goes down, maybe he draws a penalty. But he was intent on one thing, and that was beating his man wide and getting to the net.
And he did. And I agree with you. Instead of trying to draw a call, he's trying to score a goal. Second, third periods. Exactly, I think, the way Detroit wanted to start.
Big hit by Rafalski behind the play on Martin Erat. Drew a roar there from the crowd, and now here is Zetterberg. Turns, puts it in the slot. Little drop pass on the far side. Rafalski now to Zetterberg, and he just fired it. Just went wide on a tip-tac-toe play. None of the players for the Red Wings that touched it had it on their stick very long. Here's Hamhuis with a drive and a save made there by Osgood. Order chuck, but he couldn't corral it, and it's dumped by the Wings back into the Nashville zone. Zidlitsky run into. Big hit coming from Dallas Drake.
This team has supreme trust in both their goaltenders, and likewise the goaltenders and the guys in front of them.
Bronson, a rebound given up, loose puck. Samuelson a couple of swipes, but the puck wasn't there. And once again, we see the rebounds given up by Dan Ellis. By Ellis. Samuelson had 8 shots in game 1. A win here as Ellis just did get a piece of that, deflected wide.
Good save in traffic there.
Now Lidstrom takes a look across, gives it instead to Zetterberg. Zetterberg pulls it to the backhand, a shot right through, deflected. Ellis is down. Oh, and Holmstrom is just drilled. And no call coming. Zetterberg for the one-timer. That was the combination that worked for the game winner in game 1, a turnover in the neutral zone. Back comes Vernon Fiddler. He gets a shot away. Osgood the save. And Datsyuk has it now. 25 seconds left in this Red Wing power play. Datsyuk with speed into the zone. Puck knocked away, but it's recovered by Lidstrom. He sends it in deep. But he lost a stick. It was the defenseman Weber who gets one from Smithson. Now Smithson, the forward, without a stick as it comes back to the right point. Rafalski sends it across for Lidstrom. He's facing the man without the stick. Now Rafalski far side. One-timer on the way. Missed the net. Here's a chance for Datsyuk, and he misfired.
Oh, my goodness.
Looked like he had a wide open 4x6, and the puck is kicked away by Smithson. If he's a right-hand shot from there, it's probably a much easier play.
Exactly.
Weber takes a hit. Draper gets in there. Bochenski steps into him. Now a centering pass for Radulov. Just missed the mark. Comes back to the point. Zidlitsky save. Rebound chance. Good play by Doppel on the far side. Now Stewart takes over. Has it chipped off of his stick. Now Peverly. Back to the line. No. Good stick work there by Johan Franzen.
Twice. Franzen with the perfect stick in lane. He gets the clear this time. He has to put up ice pressure for the rest of his penalty killing mates to change. And then a big hit. What a sequence for Johan Franzen.
Little chip pass for Halavich. Jumped over his stick. Just a couple of seconds left in the Hogler penalty. He comes out. It's 3-on-3 right now. Drake tries to go one way. It's deflected right back to Hudler.
In terms of generating only 4 scoring chances, 3 of their 8 shots came from the point.
A steal here, and Cleary fires it wide. A dangerous turnover. Cronwall in there getting some help from Datsyuk, who pokes it ahead into open ice. And good read there by Shea Weber, who came across and got a stick on it. Weber trying to play it along. It's blocked by Datsyuk. Makes a move. Hands it off. A chance here. Shorthanded.
Home ice belongs to President Trophy winning Detroit Red Wings. They're going to have to break through at some point if they're going to win a series here at the Joe.
Bochenski was hit hard by Chelios. Now Bochenski back on the attack. Lebda does a good job on him. Now the puck goes to the corner. Predators trying to put on some pressure here. And Jordan Tootsie's shot didn't get through. And again, we have no update as to the availability of Jason Arnott or David Leguan for game 6 in New Jersey for some of those games, haven't they? Holmstrom with a big hit on him. He was right over on that Red Wing bench. Joe Louis Arena crowd reacted to that as Draper had him lined up. Zanin again. Sends it across for Shea Weber. Took an errant bounce off the board. It's picked up by Cleary. Winds up, drives the shot. Save, Ellis! And he gathers it in.
Another hit in front of Dan Ellis.
Red Wings hold it in. Now Franzen to the backhander that was steered aside by Ellis. Pushes it up to Filppula. Filppula taken down by Fiddler. Jumps right back to his skates. And the Red Wings turn it back the other way. Here's McCarty. Winds up. Drives the shot. Ellis the save. All the way out to the high slot. Cleared to the line. Held in by the Wings. Sent back in deep by Lebda. Here's McCarty. Now for Helm. Helm hands it off. A shot here. Saved by Ellis. And he will hold it here in the Stanley Cup playoffs. This play onside. Just one shot for the Nashville Predators here in period number 2. And they could get one here. Smithson toward the net. Picked up by Fogg. He fired it wide. Boy, did Osgood get a piece of that. We couldn't tell from here.
He sure made an acrobatic and athletic move on it.
Here is Zetterberg now. Heels back. Sends it across for a chance. Ellis the save there. Fishes it out to the point. Lidstrom goes back to Zetterberg. Zetterberg a couple of goals in game 1, gets it down low for Holmstrom, and Ellis able to cover up as the 2 Nashville defensemen come in Nashville. Faceoff win again cleanly by Zetterberg, a shot right through, Ellis the save, and again Holmstrom battling with Hamhuis and being careful not to react. They don't want the faceoff to come out of the zone, they don't want to take a penalty and have one of the better power play players taken off the ice. You heard so many coaches talk about it, be on the defensive side of the puck. One-timer coming here, misses the net. Bach with a chance, and Osgood makes just his second save of the second.
One of the best ones in the National Hockey League.
Even the Red Wing players talk about what a fun building it is to play in. Here's the centering pass. McCarty with a chance. Oh, and Ellis just got a piece of that as Darren McCarty comes close to establishing a 2-0 lead. Now McCarty back to the line. Here is Lebda. Goes to Chelios. Chelios tries to get it in front. That was blocked. Langfeld sends it across. Chelios, big hit. Darcy Hordichuk.
The attention to detail by the Red Wings has been impeccable. But you better start using the word brilliant for the play of Dan Ellis.
Here's a steal by Hudler. Hands it off and a shot through traffic. Missed the net. That was McCarty as well. Turnover nearly inside the line there. That's who just missed it. He gathered it in the neutral zone. Hands it off now for Holmstrom. Holmstrom back for Datsyuk. Now it's picked up by Zetterberg. Zetterberg to the forehand, circles the net. Wraparound chance, Ellis is down. No whistle yet, scramble for the puck. DeVries has it. He walks out of traffic with it. Then he's given a bump, plays it up the far side. And Radek Bonk now is trapped by a couple of Red Wings. Sends it back to the near side of the Nashville zone.
Outstanding read by the goaltender Ellis on the wraparound attempt by Zetterberg. But Franzen has been real good along with that second line we talked about. Filppula with the goal. Samuelson as well. Here's the hit on Franzen.
Boop. Face plant.
Ooh, of course. Eight shots on goal for that trio. Two scoring chances, one face plant.
Sure, he could get to the puck, and that allowed McCarty to get there and send it down the ice. McCarty with a big hit on Santa. Crowd loves that here. And so Lewis Arena as the Predators clear it back the other way. Shots are now 33-10.
Predator just has to keep going, and Nashville has to.
Centering pass, bouncing puck, Ellis down. A couple of pops at it for Samuelson, and wow.
They have to know they're still in it, and now frustration's boiling.
And Smithson at center ice gets it in deep. Pays the price, though, with Stewart with a good hit on him.
Nice pickup, Wes Stewart. So that was an underrated move by general manager Ken Holland with the Detroit Red Wings.
Lead pass could be a two-on-one here. Draper has hook, drives the shot on the save made by Ellis. Given that exchange, that this Nashville team will make the playoffs.
Chris Mason is supposed to be the goaltender. Dan Ellis, you can see why he is the goaltender,
yeah.
Playing brilliant goal.
Lidstrom with a shot through traffic, and two players are down behind Ellis, and Holmstrom this time is the one that ends up on top of the confrontation. Centering attempt hit the back of the net. Bonk again. Lobs it out. Now Shea Weber with a drive, and that was deflected away. It knocked the stick right out of the hands.
Okay.
Of Dallas Drake. Drake wanted to clear it with his glove, but he couldn't get to it on the angle now. One of the Predators takes a shot, and it rolls in on Osgood, and he holds it there with 6.5 seconds remaining. Zetterberg gets it in deep. Holmstrom in on the forecheck. Here's a steal. Centering pass. Ellis down. Puck comes free. Rafalski with a shot. Now on the angle, Ellis stops that one off the stick of Pavel Datsyuk.
Finishing their check, being in the right spot, supporting each other on the wall.
Vortichek rolls it in front, it deflects off Osgood, and then he covers up in the crease.
And that's what they had to do in this series, in this game. And there's some precedent, Mr. Schrader.
Detroit won games 5 and 6 after that series was tied 2-2 back in 2004.
Same way. Home teams taking care of business. Precursor to why they're still engaged mentally.
Zetterberg burst of speed, trying to get through on the backhand. Save Ellis, loose puck. And he just does cover up. And the puck did come free, but the referee had already blown the whistle and inserted into the lineup. Now Zetterberg gets a three. It's a 3-on-2 right now through the neutral zone for Detroit. Datsyuk sets it up on the far side for a shot. Ellis, the save, rebound, chipped at there. David Legwand with that deep bone bruise in his foot. McCarty chopped at this puck and then ran hard into Sidlitsky, but the puck didn't come out.
By the media guy put out at the beginning of the year. He's not even in the main section. He's in the system, huh? He's in the system, all right. That's the reason they're in the playoffs and in this hockey game.
Sends it across, here's Lidstrom. Hands it off, Samuelson with some speed. Samuelson makes a move to the backhand, now a little forehand, now it's the save, loose puck. Just outside the blue paint, they still scramble for it. Samuelson has it in the corner. Samuelson makes another nifty move, backhand shot blocked in front of Ellis. Pokes it ahead, Filppula could not clear. Osgood plays it around, Sidlitsky intercepts. Wanted to go right to the front of the net, still has it for a shot, save Osgood. Loose puck cleared by the Red Wing, boy Radulov was looking for the rebound.
And he may be the most dangerous player. And that was all set up by a turnover by Chris Osgood. He went back behind the net to play it. Headed it right to Sidlitsky.
Now Hudler steps inside of Sidlitsky, but the Predators get to it. And back comes Darcy Hordichuk. He puts it in deep. Draper watching him. It comes out to the far side. Suter shot on the angle, missed, and it's cleared by Longwall. Makes a nice play to escape Josh Langfeld. Now McCarty. One and two as the play is offside at the Nashville blue line. Hordichuk and McCarty have a hold of each other. And it will only be a discussion. By Lidstrom, now it comes to DeVries. DeVries hands it off. Looking for the return pass, but he was checked to the ice and the puck goes over the glass. Ellis settles it down. Suter spins away from the pressure, but more pressure coming the other way. Cleary with a big hit on the Nashville defenseman. Comes right back to him. He wheels and fires it around the net. Now taken by Dumont, a shot, and Osgood there to make the save. Don't go away, 4 points to go in regulation, 1-0 Detroit. Lidstrom sends it around far side. Holmstrom is there. takes the check, gets it back to the line. Lidstrom hands it off. Here's Datsyuk to the forehand shot. What a stop there. Erat drops it back. Here is Suter. Into the zone. Puck was turned over. Nashville just does get another defenseman on the ice. Samuelson with a shot save. Loose puck in front. Samuelson again. Nets off the mooring. How did it get off? It's going to be a penalty against Nashville.
Martin Erat. A little bit of panic, possibly.
Nice move by Zetterberg. Puck cleared by the Predators. Not out of the zone. Here's Datsyuk. Puck got a string for him. Hands it off in deep to the front of the net. Zetterberg, and the puck popped free. It just wide of that far goalpost. Pavel Datsyuk with it. Datsyuk hands it off down low for Holmstrom. 35 seconds left in the man advantage. A pass across Zetterberg. Backhand shot. And that missed Ellis, and it missed the net.
Zetterberg's missed two glorious scoring chances in the third. Datsyuk hit the outside of the net. Datsyuk missed a mostly open net in the first.
What a move here by Zetterberg. He gets in. Weber takes it to the outside. Zetterberg tried to center it. But boy, the Predators recovered quickly. A dozen seconds left in the power play for Detroit.
Especially the skill guys having the chances that they've missed on.
He ran out of the box as Franzen gets a shot away. And Ellis alertly plays it quickly. But the Predators can't take advantage and get anything in transition. Coppola tags up. Ellis hands it off to Zidlitsky. We'll keep an eye on Ellis now down to our left. Inside a minute and a half remaining in regulation. Bomb centering pass. Deflected puck comes away. Ellis gets to the bench. Empty net down to our left. This puck will roll slowly down into the Nashville zone. It won't be icing. And the crowd at Joe Louis Arena all on their feet as it comes down to Beverly toward Oscar. With a minute six remaining here in regulation time, a timeout has been called. Six skaters on for Nashville against the five for the Red Wings. Zetterberg to take the draw for Detroit. One cleanly by the Predators. Here's Suter. One timer missed the net. Boy, that had plenty on it. Peverly back to Zidlitsky. Back to Peverly. Less than a minute remaining now in regulation. Down low. The Predators pressing. Now it comes straight away to Zidlitsky. Zidlitsky hands it off on the far side. Peverly takes a look. Hands it off down low. Centering pass. Body to the net. They score. It's in. The Predators have tied the game with 43.4 seconds remaining in regulation.
Beautiful execution. A couple of different times they win the faceoff. They keep it in the zone. And I told you the silence, deafening. Here at Joe Louis Arena. Here at off the back. Well, watch them. No presence. Make sure they're going to take a good play. Calm. Quick.
Radek Bonk getting the goal for the Nashville Predators. What a play. His first point. First goal of the series.
And there's the jubilation. No chance for Chris Osgood. You have to give the Nashville Predators all the credit in the world as the fans try to rally their Detroit Red Wings.
4.7 seconds on the clock. Zetterberg. Tied up by Smithson, effectively the puck rolls harmlessly to the end board, and that is going to do it for 60 minutes. Now Fiddler kicks it ahead for Smithson. Smithson drives the shot, Osgood the save.
Everybody wants to know. Lots of guys to choose from who have that in their history in this game on the Detroit side of the ledger. And Nashville's playoff overtime goal would be the first in franchise history.
Conwell drives it along the boards behind Ellis. Samuelson back to the line, and that didn't get all the way through to Ellis. Here's Coppola now. Now Coppola along the end board. Franzen in there deep as well for the Red Wings, and now Peverly hands it off. Suter checked for behind there by Coppola. Turnover, lead pass behind the defense. Franzen comes in on Ellis to the backhand. He scores!
Relief and frustration on the face of that man.
Johan Franzen scored the first goal of this series, and he has just scored the most important goal of this series in overtime.
Quick transition in the neutral zone. You said, did they change anything? No, because they have this capacity. The hole in the middle of the offense, Franzen Coppola answering here this evening for the Detroit Red Wings.
Nicholas Cronwall, I believe, with a nice headman pass and to the backhand, and no mistake for Johan Franzen. 1 minute and 48 seconds into the overtime, the Red Wings have taken a 3-2 lead back to Somay Center for Sunday afternoon.
They held serve on home ice, as has been the history in this series.
So the first third period goal by a Nashville team in playoff competition at Joe Louis Arena was deflating, but it just prolonged the jubilation that eventually came from these fans here at Joe Louis Arena.